Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hany Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this video, we are going to see now how we can use filters and EVM in Primavera. So in the previous session, we learned how to create a small time schedule and how to read the schedule from P6. Now we understand the differences between baseline schedule and the updated schedule. In this session, we will import two schedules. You can download from the link below. Assign baseline, make filter, and extract EVM terms directly from P6 without any manual calculations. Let us see how Primavera will calculate them. So first of all, you need to import these two files. You can find the download link below. Please download and import and open the first update and maintain this one as a baseline and then assign as a baseline. If you don't remember, please refer to the previous video. Okay, so here we have the baseline first update and the project baseline is assigned correctly. Now we would like to show the baseline bar in our schedule to see the variances between the planned and actual, and now start looking at our time schedule. So simply right click on the Gantt chart area here, you just right click and select bars, and from bars choose the baseline bar. You will find here primary baseline. You can choose it, select the color for it. I prefer to have it as a black so it will not be confusing. So whenever you see something black here, it means this is your baseline schedule and the other colors are your updated schedule. So the black color will appear underneath the red or blue color. The red, it means critical. Let me tell you the differences between the colors of the updated schedule. This blue means it is started and completed. As you can see here, this is our data deadline. So whatever before the data deadline, it means it already happened. Whatever after the data deadline, it means it is forecast. So we might see here something green, it means this activity is not critical. If it is red, it means this activity is critical. Okay, so let's go and see how we can do this in the Primavera schedule and how simple it is. So this is the previous screen we just created in the previous lesson. Now we would like to do some modifications. First, we would like to show the baseline. Before doing this, I'll be sure that in my project assign baseline, I have here baseline assigned. If I cannot find list of baselines here, it means I didn't make the maintained yet. So in that case, I have to go from project and maintain baseline, then I have to do the maintain step. Now right click bars, as you can see here, we can enlarge this one a little bit. I need the primary baseline. I will choose the width of it. I will choose the color as black. Okay, here. Then I will choose to display and I will click apply. As you can see here, now I'm start seeing the baseline bars in my time schedule. Simply I can say where I am behind, where I am ahead, just from looking to the bar chart. Let me shrink the bar chart a little bit. So from one look, I can tell these activities are started and finished on time. This activity finished a little bit late because this bar is after this bar. This activity is starting very late. So I have now all the schedule. I can see that this activity is critical, the masonry in the first floor, because it is red. I can see this fire alarm activity is critical. So now I can say and tell my project team what is going on by doing these simple steps. Of course, I'm expecting from you in this course level that you only be able to open a project, maintain the baseline, check what is going on. I'm not expecting from you to create such a schedule. If you are interested in the planning itself, we have other courses which will tell you how to create everything. But now, since we are talking about the overall picture, the big picture of the project management, what I'm interested to tell you here is to open a schedule, see what is going on it. What if we need to do some filters? I have a very big schedule. I need to do some filters. So in that case, we can use the filter icon in our time schedule. And this will give us the opportunity to make very nice filters. Let's try one of them. Now we will create a filter to filter the critical activities. This filter will show the activity only with zero float. So I'm expecting to see something like this after applying the filter. It will show me the activities which has zero float. Let's do it. So from here, I can use the filter and show only the critical activities. This is ready-made filter, by the way, in the P6. So you can simply use it, click apply. Now I can print this one or save it as a PDF and send it to my team. Okay, gentlemen, you are delayed in the slab. This affecting this one. We need to accelerate the masonry work in the first floor. We need to do fire alarm on time. Maybe you can start earlier to eliminate the expected delays. What other filters I can do as well? Let's try another one. Not started filter. It filters activities that haven't started yet. So I can simply from here select not started activity, and this one will show for me the not started activity. Let's see how to do it. First of all, I need to clear my previous filter. So I'll show all the activities from here. Then I can simply select not started and select apply this, the activity that not started. And I can mix two filters together. So let's say I need the not started and the critical activity. I can show them like this. So I mix two filters together. It will show for me the critical activities and not started as well. We can check another filter, which is text. We need to filter only the activities for the ground floor. So in this schedule, all ground floor activity has the term GF, which is a shortcut for ground floor in the activity name. So in that case, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new folder and choose the activity name that contains ground floor. Very simple. I will create a filter like this, activity name contained GF, and then I can name it as a ground floor activity, save it for later on if I would like to use it again. Then I can make the filter like this, so it will show me the activity with ground floor. So here we can do it simply by making filters. First of all, I'll clear my previous filter, then I'll create a new one. I'll call it ground floor activities, and here I will choose from here activity name. Don't use equals, because equals will give you the exact one. I need only contains. So from here, contains GF, click OK. I have here my filter, and then I'll click apply to see the activities with this criteria. As I can see here, only the ground floor activities are shown. Now we would like to talk a little bit about the EVM in P6. What I mean by EVM in P6? Do you remember the EVM term that we discussed before, like planned value, planned percentage, and SPI, CPI? No need to calculate them manually. P6 can calculate all of them automatically. We will show the planned value, earned value, planned percentage, actual percentage, SPI, and the schedule variance. How we can do this? Simply, if you remember these columns, we just need to show the columns that we require to see, and Primavera will do all the math automatically. So we'd like to create this schedule, create these columns. Can you do it? Try pausing the video and try to do them by yourself. We have here original duration, planned project start, planned project finish, start, finish, schedule percentage complete, performance percentage complete, budget total cost, planned value, earned value, schedule performance index, schedule variance, and total float. I will do it in front of you, so when you are trying to do it by yourself, it will be easy for you. So simply, I'm going to select my columns. I have your activity ID, activity name, original duration. Now I need to show the planned start date, and from dates here I can find it. Planned PL project finish, PL project start. Now I can rearrange them. So I have a start and I have finish. Now I have the start and finish, which give me dates for the updated schedule. I need the schedule percentage complete. From here I can search schedule and I can find next, like this. Or if I know the location of it, because I know the location, it is in the percentage complete. I can go to percentage complete and find it directly. So it is here. I have here schedule percentage complete. It will be down because S letter. Then performance percentage complete, which is the actual. Then I need the budgeted total cost. I can find it in the course. You can search for it also. And it is not a bad idea to just explore these menus to see what is inside. Here I need the budgeted total cost. Then I need the planned value. From the earned value here, you can find the planned value. Planned value cost. Then we have the earned value cost. We need it. Earned value cost. Schedule performance index. I can find it like this. Schedule. You can search for the whole term or part of it. Performance, then find next. So this is a schedule performance index. And then we need the schedule variance. Here it is, schedule variance. After I finish all my columns, I can click apply. Okay. And now I can just make it like this. So my screen will accommodate all my data. I need this one very small. You can now adjust your schedule according to the space you have in the paper or the screen. By the way, you can sort your activities inside the WBS by clicking any of these columns. So here I'll sort it like this, planned start or as per the planned finish. You can sort it. Now you know the main idea. I'm sure that you like it. Try to do it by yourself. I hope you find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.